मास कीलप पावूर।
हाय वेलकम टू मास कीलप पावूर चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर अरुणा शनमुगवेल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द ओरिजिन, कोर्स, फंक्शन एंड क्लिनिकल एनाटॉमी ऑफ काडा टिम्पानी नर्व। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द सेशन लेट अस सी अ कोट। बीइंग बोथ सॉफ्ट एंड स्ट्रांग इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन Very few have mastered. Shall we enter into the session? The cauda tympani nerve is the pre-traumatic branch of first pharyngeal arch. It arises from the facial nerve 6 millimeter above the stylomastoid foramen, while the facial nerve descends in the vertical part of facial canal. The nerve then enters into the posterior canaliculus in the posterior wall of medullary cavity. Runs medial to the upper part of tympanic membrane. It passes between fibrous and mucous layers of tympanic membrane medial to handle of malleus. It exits from the medullary cavity through anterior canaliculus at the medial end of petrotympanic fissure. Can you recollect the petrotympanic fissure? Yes. It lies in the mandibular fossa of the temporal bone. The squamotympanic fissure is divided into two more fissures by downturned edge of tegment tympani. The fissures are petrosquamous and petrotympanic. Out of these two, there are three structures in the petrotympanic fissure, that is anterior canaliculus for cauda tympani, anterior tympanic branch of first part of maxillary artery, anterior ligament of malleus. Okay, now the cauda tympani nerve has come out through anterior canaliculus. Then it runs medial to the spine of sphenoid, making a groove in it. Remember, lateral to the spine of sphenoid is the auriculotemporal nerve. After traversing the medial aspect of spine of sphenoid, the nerve runs deep to lateral pterygoid muscle, and 2 centimeter below the skull, it joins with the lingual nerve from behind at an acute angle in the infratemporal fossa. Just before joining with lingual nerve, cauda tympani nerve receives a small branch from otic ganglion. Through lingual nerve, the general visceral efferent fibers are carried to the submandibular and sublingual salivary glands, and special visceral afferent fibers from anterior two-third of tongue except circumvallate papilla. Shall we trace the general visceral efferent fibers of cauda tympani? Right. These fibers are preganglionic parasympathetic fibers and start from superior salivary nucleus, which is present in pons. The fibers pass through nervous intermedius, facial nerve, cauda tympani, lingual nerve, and then relayed in the submandibular ganglion. The postganglionic fibers directly reach the submandibular gland, whereas the same for sublingual gland re-enter the lingual nerve from submandibular ganglion and supply. The special visceral afferent fibers, that is traced from anterior two-third of tongue except circumvallate papillae, pass through cauda tympani fibers that are carried within the lingual nerve. Then from cauda tympani nerve, the fibers enter the facial nerve and finally reach the cranial part of nucleus of tractus solitarius in the medulla oblongata. Shall we move on to the clinical anatomy of cauda tympani? The common sources of damage to cauda tympani nerve are ear infection, otalgic surgery, dental anesthesia, removal of lower third molar, laryngoscopy, intubation, that is insertion of a breathing tube. When cauda tympani is damaged, taste sensation from anterior two-third of tongue will be lost. secretomotor fibers to submandibular and sublingual salivary glands will be affected. Kara tympani syndrome is an uncommon condition with similarities to Frey's syndrome. The features of this syndrome are reduced saliva secretion, loss of taste in the anterior two-thirds of tongue, increased pain response in tongue, increased taste perception of salt, phantom taste, that is, tasting things that are not there, changes in the mouth feel of food and beverages. Shall we end up the session with a quote? Slow progress is better than no progress. Thank you for watching.
If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon. Select all to get instant notifications.